Remove the home parenteral nutrition, or HPN, bag and any vitamins or medicines sent by the pharmacy from the refrigerator 1 hour before the infusion or bag change is due. Inspect the HPN bag to make sure the fluid is clear. It has no pockets of air, no particles, no streaking, and it is not leaking. Check the label on the HPN bag. Make sure the label information is correct, including the patient's name and date of birth. Verify the use-by date to make sure the bag is not expired. Check the amount of HPN, vitamins, and medicines you should give. Repeat this process to verify patient information and amounts to give for the vitamins and medicines sent by the pharmacy. When it's time to give the infusion or change the bag, clean your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Cover your work surface with a paper drape or a clean towel. This work surface is now a safe zone or a clean area. Put the supplies and equipment you need onto the safe zone. The HPN bag, 2 vitamin bottles, and medicines. A Curlin 6000 infusion pump. Curlin IV tubing with an appropriate size filter. Alcohol pads. Chlorhexidine pads. A pre-filled saline flush syringe. Empty syringes with an attached needle, one for the vitamin bottles, and one for each medicine bottle, and a sharps container. Put 2C batteries and an AC power cord, if you'd like to use one to power the pump, next to the safe zone. Most HPN formulas require you to put vitamins or medicines into the bag just before the infusion begins. Never add vitamins or medicines to the HPN bag more than 1 hour before you start the infusion. Check the label on the vitamin bag to confirm the amount of vitamins to add to the HPN. To prepare the vitamins, remove the cap from each vitamin bottle. Scrub the rubber center of each bottle with a new alcohol pad for 15 to 30 seconds. Allow to air dry. Remove the syringe with an attached needle from its packaging. Twist the needle hub to tighten the connection between the needle and the syringe. Pull to remove the cap from the needle. Put the cap onto the safe zone. Push the needle into the center of the first vitamin bottle. Turn the bottle upside down. Slowly pull the syringe back until the tip of the needle is in the neck of the bottle, below the fluid level. Pull down on the plunger until you see the correct amount of fluid in the syringe. You may need to pull the tip of the needle further down into the neck of the bottle to get all of the fluid you need. Turn the bottle right side up and set it on the safe zone. Pull the syringe to remove the needle from the bottle. Hold the syringe with the needle pointing toward the ceiling. Tap the barrel with your finger to force air bubbles up toward the needle. Push gently on the syringe plunger to push air bubbles out of the syringe. Use the same syringe and repeat the process with the second vitamin bottle. Use a scooping motion to pick up the needle cap from the safe zone. Push the cap firmly onto the needle. Set the syringe on the safe zone. If the needle touches something that is not sterile, replace it with a new sterile needle. If the pharmacy sent medicines in bottles, use a new syringe with a needle attached for each bottle. Follow the same steps for checking the label to see how much medicine to pull into the syringe, cleaning the top of the medicine bottle, and withdrawing medicine. Remove any bubbles from the syringe and replace the cap. Continue to follow these steps until you have pulled all vitamins and medicines into syringes. Scrub the injection port on the HPN bag for 15 to 30 seconds with an alcohol pad. Carefully lay the bag on the safe zone without letting the injection port touch the surface. Allow the port to air dry. Remove the cap from the needle on the vitamin syringe. Insert the needle straight into the center of the injection port on the HPN bag. Do not poke the needle into the side of the injection port or the bag. Push the syringe plunger until all of the fluid has been added to the bag. Then remove the needle from the injection port. Put the empty syringe with the needle attached into the sharps container. Repeat these steps with each syringe, including vitamins, medicines, and any pre-filled medicine syringes sent by the pharmacy. If you're using a dual-chamber HPN bag, pull the flexible cord completely out of the plastic holder. Turn the bag over and pull the plastic holder away from the bag. Whether you're using a dual or single chamber bag, gently rock the bag until all contents are mixed together and there are no streaks or oily layers in the fluid. Remove the tab on the HPN bag's tubing port. Lay the bag on the safe zone, making sure the tubing port does not touch the surface. Remove the Curlin IV tubing from its package. Twist to remove the tab from the yellow flow stop device in the IV tubing. Pull to remove the cap from the IV tubing spike. Push the tubing spike into the tubing port on the HPN bag using a twisting back and forth motion. Keep pushing and twisting the spike until it reaches the HPN fluid in the bag and cannot be pushed any further. Lift the latch on the top of the pump to open the pump door. Insert the blue tubing guide into the holder on the right side of the pump. Lay the tubing in the center of the gray track. Insert the yellow flow stop device into the holder on the left side of the pump. Close the pump door and press the latch down until it clicks. Press the on button on the pump. Listen for the beeps that tell you the self-tests are complete. Immediately after the self-test, the battery icon appears on the display window. Check to make sure there is enough battery power to run the infusion. If it shows there is less than 1/4 battery power left, change the batteries. We'll talk about how to change the batteries later in this video. The display window highlights Program. Press the Yes, Enter button. The display window shows Repeat Rx. Press the Yes, Enter button. The pump automatically scrolls through the infusion program. Make sure the numbers on the pump match the pharmacy label on the HPN bag. If the pump scrolled too quickly for you to review the program, press No to review. Then press the down arrow to Next. Press the Yes button. Use the down arrow to scroll through and verify the numbers match the label. When you're finished, press the Yes button. Put the end of the IV tubing onto the safe zone. Hold the filter in the IV tubing upright. Do not turn the filter upside down. Press and hold the Prime button. Keep holding the filter upright while you prime the IV tubing. When the HPN fluid reaches the tip of the IV tubing, release the Prime button. Check the IV tubing and filter to make sure there are no air bubbles larger than soda pop bubbles. If there are bubbles, repeat the priming steps by pressing and holding the Prime button until all air bubbles are removed from the tubing. When all of the air bubbles in the tubing and filter are gone, press the Yes, Enter button. Before you start the HPN infusion, flush the IV catheter with saline. To prepare the saline flush syringe, remove the cap and lay it on the safe zone with the open end toward the ceiling. Push up gently on the plunger to remove any air from the syringe. Carefully put the cap back onto the tip of the syringe. Put the syringe onto the safe zone. Scrub the hub of the needleless connector on the IV catheter with a chlorhexidine pad for 15 to 30 seconds. Allow the connector to air dry. Attach the syringe to the hub of the needleless connector. Open the clamp on the IV catheter. Use the push-pause method to slowly push the fluid from the syringe into the IV catheter. Hold on to the needleless connector and remove the syringe. Scrub the hub of the needleless connector again with a new chlorhexidine pad for 15 to 30 seconds. Allow the hub to air dry. Attach the HPN bag's IV tubing to the needleless connector. Make sure all clamps on the IV tubing and IV catheter are open. Press the Run button on the pump to start the infusion. Check to make sure the pump is running. You'll see a flashing green light when the pump is running. Check the pump every few hours to make sure it is running and there is less fluid in the bag. If you press the pause button to stop the pump during an infusion, it's important to know how to restart the infusion. If you stop the pump before the HPN bag is finished and want to continue the infusion where you left off, press the up or down arrow to highlight Resume. Press the Yes, Enter button, then press the Run button. If you are starting a new bag, you must return to the beginning of the program. Press the up or down arrow button to highlight Repeat Rx. Press the Yes, Enter button. The display window shows Alert, Rx in progress. Yes to repeat. No to return. Press the Yes, Enter to repeat. The pump scrolls through the program. Verify the numbers on the pump match the bag label. When you're ready, press the Run button. The pump beeps when the infusion is finished. And the display window shows Infusion Complete. Press the pause button, then the off button to turn the pump off. To disconnect from the Curlin pump, first clean your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Cover your work surface with a paper drape or clean towel to create a safe zone. Put your supplies onto the safe zone. Chlorhexidine pads, a pre-filled saline flush syringe, and a pre-filled heparin flush syringe. Prepare the flush syringes. Disconnect the IV tubing from the needleless connector. Lift the latch on the top of the pump to open the door. Remove the IV tubing from the pump. It is normal for there to be a small amount of HPN left in the bag after the infusion is finished. Put the used IV tubing and HPN bag into the trash. Scrub the hub of the IV catheter, then flush with a pre-filled saline flush syringe following the same steps you used before the infusion. Scrub the hub of the IV catheter, then flush using a pre-filled heparin flush syringe. Close the clamp on the IV catheter, then remove the heparin flush syringe. Put all of the used supplies into the trash. Clean your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. There are two ways to power the Curlin pump: AC power and battery power. To run the pump using AC power, push the power cord adapter into the port on the bottom of the pump. Plug the other end of the adapter into an AC power outlet. To run the pump on batteries, disconnect the power cord adapter from the pump. Always make sure you have enough battery power for the infusion. Remember to check the battery icon when you first start the pump. Change the batteries if you see less than 1/4 battery power left. To check the battery charge level during an infusion, press Power Check, located on the number 2 button. The display window shows how much power is left in the batteries. When the batteries are low or empty, the pump beeps, and the display window shows low C batteries or empty battery. Press the pause button, then the off button to turn the pump off. To insert new batteries, move the gray bar on the back of the pump to the unlock position. Slide the battery door down to remove it from the pump. Pull the plastic tab to remove the old batteries. Replace them with 2 new batteries. Replace the battery door by sliding it into the notches at the bottom of the pump. Move the gray bar to the lock position. If you want to continue the infusion, press the on button to turn on the pump. The display window highlights Program. Press the Yes, Enter button. The display window highlights Resume. Press the Yes, Enter button. Then press Run to restart the HPN infusion. Check to make sure the green light is flashing and the pump is running.